because we don't reincarnate, our personality is never reincarnate. This point I have hammered again and again, it's in all my videos. Basically only our vasana samskara is reincarnate. The unique personality that we have in this lifetime never incarnates.
That is gone forever, right?
That is gone forever. That is gone forever. We shouldn't go looking for it. But in many senses, we tend to be the same people again because the vasana samskara, the desires, habits, tendencies, all of them, they keep agglomerating a similar. But the unique personality is a one-off. The unique personality is a one-off, it never incarnates. So to recognize somebody as my soulmate from many lifetimes is again a blunder. Yes, there are soulmates and there are twin flames and all that. But all that means is that there is a lot of karmic issues between the two of you. A lot of karmic give and take left between the two of you. It's not never the personality. It's never ever the personality. The unique personality is never there. This again is not well understood except by those in hardcore yoga. Most people think that reincarnation means the personality reincarnates. Actually, you'll never again find your unique personality. And of course, when people are memories of past life, they are always rich and famous people. They are always great people. They are never people cleaning the stables and working in the fields, you know. They are always riding the horse and living in palaces. So those are all imaginations. The authentic memories of past lives come in meditation. All past life regression and all that. Maybe sometimes they are okay, most of the time they are not. They just induce memories. Induced memories is becoming a very, very important area of psychological discipline now. And you realize it's so easy to construct a reality, it's so easy to construct remembrance of an incident or an episode. You can just, by giving the smallest of chabis to people, you can make them believe that something happened. And they will pass a lie detector test with no problem. 100% conviction. So memories of past lives, most of the time I'm not interested because I know it's just created memory. It's not a real memory.
I wanted to ask a question. How do you do what we call past life regression? And my second follow-up question is, how will it help you to understand karma?
When you are in deep meditation, there is a process. It is called the Punya Smriti or the Purna Smriti. The pure remembrance or the full remembrance. Before you get enlightened, it is a necessary but not sufficient condition for enlightenment. You have to remember all your lifetimes from the time you were an amoeba. So, from unicellular to plant to animal, multiple, then human, then finally till you come. So it happens. Whatever is necessary for you to grow in your current incarnation, those memories usually surface. So if the memory surfaces in meditation, it's usually an authentic memory. If the memory surfaces in hypnosis and those kind of things, unless the person is a very good yogi himself, it's normally not the real deal. It's normally something that you're reconstructing from the environment, that you're reconstructing from what you've learned, heard, those kind of things. So I have I have no patience
past life regression, which everyone's talking about today.
Because people are lazy. They don't want to do the meditation themselves. Yes. It's so much easier to give responsibility to another person. It's very dangerous. Yoga is very dangerous that way because you can go deep into this yogic state and then you can go and you can start creating a whole world. You can become a creator of a whole universe. You get lost in that. Which is why certain sages, they get locked into samadhi 10-20 years, they don't come out of the cave. Because they are busy creating another world, can actually slip into another dimension where you are basically Brahman.
Similar to Inception?
Yeah, very similar to Inception. Exactly like Inception.
That's what I'm saying?
Yeah, exactly like Inception. You can just start mentally recreating a world and
you are locked into that.
So, good teachers warn you against that. They tell you that. Don't fall for that trap because it's so intoxicating and you are basically God over there. Because you are creating the world.
And then you don't want to come out of that.
Exactly.
You don't know what I'm saying. You are intoxicated with that power of creation.
And you get locked there. So that's it. You are stuck. You are blocked. The universe has multiple ways to prevent you from evolving too fast. So it's a very dangerous thing. So I don't I don't take anybody's memory of past life seriously at all, unless I can check them out and I know, okay, they are serious yogis, and if they say they found it in meditation, then just because you are attending some yoga ashram or you are learning something, and then usually you become full of spiritual bullshit after that, and then you have all these extraordinary memories. One of the very dangerous things is you end up with a group where everybody has memories of being unique and special people in previous lifetimes. So they don't challenge you on your nonsense beliefs, and you know, so. But yeah, basically I don't have any patience with past life regression. Can be done only by an authentic enlightened master, and it can be done only when you yourself are at a certain level of yoga. There are certain very strict parameters in which past life regression can be done in yoga, not the way it is done left, right and center today. And most of them are pure and simple bullshit.
I see.
The memories that come up are all manufactured memories. Nobody remembers being a South Sea Polynesian Islander. Nobody remembers being an Australian or an, yeah, you know, like nobody remembers hunting animals in Africa. How come?
What do they remember?
They remember everything from within their culture and within their domain, whatever is within the possible knowledge base they remember, whatever is in the atmosphere. Nobody remembers anything besides outside their cultural or their psychological parameters.
So they have read about, say, Europe in the books, they say 18th century Europe, I was.
Had a very famous example. Somebody had a memory of being a cheese seller in medieval Europe, in rags, you know, the full romance of rags. And
rags.
Yeah, you know, the patchwork robes in rags and with a, you know, with a basket in which
it's
there were
cheese.
Yes. And you know, then she was chased by armored knights on horseback across this meadow. You know, so full, I can see the full 70mm Braveheart kind of thing play out. You know, and then they slew her with their swords. So I asked her, "You're sure they killed you with their swords? You're sure they killed you with their swords? You were a cheese seller in rags and they killed you with their swords." He said, "Yes, yes, yes." I said, "Not possible." "What? How? What do you mean? How can you, my authentic past life memory?" I said, "Armored knights on swords meant they were noblemen. They would never use their swords on a serf. They would use an axe, they would use a spear, they would use a club.
Sword is sacred.
They would run you down with their horse. But steel is for gentlemen. They would never ever, unless it was a battle, there was no way they would draw their sword and use it on a serf." Now, because I know my history, of course that meant the end of the friendship, because you know there was so much investment in that, in that false memory. In that false memory. It is pure and simple bullshit. Armored horseman means your nobility. If the other knights come to know you use your sword, that's it. You know, you are done for. You are finished. You know, after that you have to become a bandit. You know? So this is just one prime example. But the whole romance of, you know, even there you are special. Nobility chases you. You know, nobility chases you, and you run so fast you can outrun their horses in a meadow. So you know, the whole inflated, gaseous self-importance that come over people when they think they are spiritual, you know, that whole sense of uniqueness, you know, that and that of course explains why they have certain weaknesses in the body, because that is where the sword went in. You know, that's all bullshit. Now, if she had told me they set the dogs on me or they rode, trampled me with the horse, I would have said yes. That's what European nobility were like. That's exactly what they would have done. But they will use their sword on a serf. Come on. It's just... So yeah, that basically I don't have much patience for these kind of... Because these are all induced memories. These are all induced memories. These are all things you pick up.